Yes, welcome students. I hope you all are fine. Now we will continue from the last session, the subject science. What is the lesson we are seeing? What is the lesson we are seeing now? Can you tell me the topic? Yeah, good. Food, where does it come from? Food, where does it come from? Have you all had your meals? Have you all had your meals? What do you mean by meals? Just try to recollect the point which was taught you in the last session. Meal. Yeah, good. The food taken at one time of a day is called as meal. The food taken at one time of a day is called as meal. Then what are the types in that? They are the morning breakfast, lunch, evening snacks, and then dinner. Fine. Now we will go for a small gym, brain gym exercise. Now we will go for small brain gym exercise. Okay. Just follow my instructions, what I say. Clear? If I say hi, you must say hello. If I say hello, you must say hi. Clear? Shall we go? Yeah. Hi. Hello. Hello. Hi. Hi, hello. Hello, hi. Hi, hello, hi. Hello, hi. Hi, hi. Hello. Are you able to follow it? Yeah, good. Now we will continue our class. These are the content which we have covered: introduction and definition of food, functions of food, meals, types of food, sources of food, and then interesting type of food. Today we are going to see about interesting types of food, mode of nutrition in animals, and then we will have a short recap on it. Okay, fine. So what are the interesting types of food? So can anyone tell me the definition of food? What is the definition of food? What is the definition of food? Yeah, good. Food is nothing but which gives us energy to do work. Food is nothing but which gives us energy to do work. What are the functions of food? Yeah, children, what are the functions of food? Maintaining body temperature, helps in development, growth and development of body, and then it helps in fight against diseases. Good. And meals, we have seen types of food. They are vegetarian and non-vegetarian food. What are the types of food? Vegetarian and what is the one more one? Non-vegetarian. Okay, then try to say some examples of vegetarian food. Good. Then one more thing, non-vegetarian. Tell me some examples. Okay, good. Then sources of food. What are the sources? They are the plant source and the animal source. Plant source and animal source. In that, what we have seen? Edible parts of plants and then non-edible parts. Yeah. What do you mean by edible parts, Pa? What do you mean by edible parts of plant? Try to tell. It may be correct or wrong. Just open your mouths. Yeah. So the part of plant which we are able to eat, the parts of plant which we are able to eat is called as edible. And then non-edible, which we are not able to eat. Okay, good. Now we will see about interesting types of food, mode of nutrition, and then recap. Okay. So what are the other interesting types of food? What is the first one? Sprouts. What do you mean by sprouts? Just repeat it. Sprouts. Sprouts are nothing but germinating seeds. Sprouts are nothing but germinating seeds. What do you mean by the word germinate? Germination. What do you mean by the word germination? That means it has small outgrowth, growing. Okay. When we plant a small seed in the soil, it grows out, no? It is called as germination. Okay. So, dry seeds like mung can be taken. It can be put in some water. So, after a day, the small outgrowth is obtained in it. These outgrowth are called as sprouts. So, it can be eaten raw without cooking. So, it is rich in proteins, vitamins and then minerals. These sprouts are rich in protein, vitamins and then minerals. Now, the next type. What is that? Honey. I think you all would like honey, right? So, from where do we get honey? The honey are prepared by honeybees from nectar collected from flowers. So, these honey are collected by honeybees from the nectar of flowers. So, I'll tell you something about honey now. So, where does this honey store? The honeybees store the honey. The place where the honeybees store honey is called as beehive. The place where the honeybees store honey is called beehive. So, what are present in that beehive? There are three types of honeys present in that beehive. The first one is the queen bee. The queen bee is the leader of that beehive. Each beehive has one queen bee, male bee and then worker bees. Okay. So, this honey bee is the leader and it will be monitoring everything. Then, the male bees are nothing. They will be sitting simply in that beehive and then they are used only for the purpose of reproduction. Okay. And then, the last one is the worker bee, but they are the most important part of the beehive because they helps in collecting the honey from the flowers. So, this honey is rich in nutrients like vitamins, minerals and carbohydrates. Clear? So, this honey is used as a sweetener. You are able to see a picture here. The honeybee is sucking nectar from the flower. Next. So, now try to answer this question. Honey is made from. Try to answer this question. Honey is made from. Your options are sprouts, flower, nectar. Honey is made from sprouts, flower or nectar. Okay, good, good. So, your answer is option C, nectar. Flower, you can say flowers, but the nectar is present in the flowers, but honey is prepared from the nectar, not from the flower, okay? But the flower has nectar. Without flower, there is no nectar. Without nectar, there is no honey. Clear? Next one. So, modes of nutrition in animals. Modes of nutrition in animals. So, what are the modes of nutrition in animals? Now, we will go into it, okay? Here, you are able to see the picture. What are the pictures you are able to see here? A lion eating the flesh. Then, deer eating the grass. By seeing this, what does comes to your mind? Nothing but, what does come to your mind? The plant eating and the flesh eating. So, they are vegetarians and then non-vegetarians. okay, but this vegetarians and non-vegetarians are based on the human beings. Clear? This vegetarians and non-vegetarians are based on the human beings, not for the animals. So based on these modes of nutrition in animals, they are classified into two types. They are the herbivore, carnivore, and then omnivore. Clear? So, and then now we will look into this. Okay. So, the organisms which prepare their own food are called autotrophs. The organisms which are not able to prepare their own food are called heterotrophs. Listen to me clearly. Autotrophs, the organisms which are able to prepare their own food are called autotrophs. See that word auto, that means it can do it automatically. Clear? Trophs is nothing but nourishment, that means energy. Clear? And then hetero, hetero means others, they are dependent on others. And then tropes means the same energy or the nourishment. Now we will able to see what is the difference between autotrophs and heterotrophs. First, autotroph, self feeder, that is nothing but they are able to prepare their own food. Self feeder, nothing but they are able to prepare their own food. And then heterotrophs. So, they are not able to prepare their own food, but dependent on others. Clear? And then the second point, make food from inorganic molecules. That means the plants get food by eating other organisms. Now, try to tell me an example of autotrophs. Tell me quick. Yeah, good. So, autotrophs example, plants. Heterotrophs, animals including human beings. Clear? Example of autotrophs is plants, and then hetero, animals including human beings. So, they are called, autotrophs are called as producers. They produce. So, plants, whether we are able to produce? No. Plants can be grown by its own. So they are the producers. The one they which eat the producers are called as consumers. The one which depend on the producers are called as consumers. Up to this clear? Yeah. Autotrophs prepare their own food. Heterotrophs depend on the others and then make food from inorganic molecules, eat food by eating other organisms. Now, example of autotrophs are plants. For heterotrophs, lion, tiger, etc. Cow, human beings, all comes under the category of heterotrophs. Up to this, I hope you are clear. Yeah? Okay. If you have any doubts, don't hesitate to ask. Just ask it in the group. Now, we will continue the remaining in the next session. Thank you, Pa.